don't forget you have a physical today at 1 o'clock.
For the 100th time, Lois, I won't forget. Nag, nag, nag. Sometimes I think I should have married that woman I met the night of my bachelor party. Lois, I'm going to my physical now.
Okay, honey, I'll see you later.
What the hell, I'll just ask it. Why do we need the horse suit for that?
Okay. All right, that's 7 16-ounce steaks.
Oh, I can't do it. I'm so full.
Full of what, estrogen? Come on, take the skirt off, you pansy.
Oh.
Let's go. Chow down, Mary Jane.
Oh, I said I can't.
Eat it. Eat
no.
the damn steak.
Come on, what are you waiting for?
Eat it, Joe.
No,
eat
no,
it.
No. Yeah. I said I'm not hungry!
Yeah, nobody's judging you, man. It's cool. I'll just put this back in your purse next to your tampons.
Hi, honey. How was your physical?
Good. Yeah. Too good, matter of fact. You know what the doctor said? Doctor said I was too healthy, you know? In too good of shape. Don't even know how. Too good of shape.
You didn't go to your physical, did you?
I did not.
Peter, I think maybe you're in denial about this fat thing.
Oh, yeah? Well, I challenge you to prove to me that I'm fat.
Okay, hang on. All right, watch this.
What the hell? What is this? What is this, some kind of gag?
Now back to the Three Stooges.
Oh. Twit a hula hoop.
Huh, that's weird.
I didn't know you had a brother.
I don't. I mean, I don't think so.
Hello, Pumpkin.
Hello, Daddy.
Did I miss your piano recital?
No, Daddy, I'm in my 40s now.
Good God!
I had a question I wanted to ask. Do I have a brother?
No, don't be silly.
Because I found this picture.
The subscriber you are trying to reach is unavailable or outside the calling area.
Are you sure this is a good idea?
Daddy's never gonna tell me the truth. The only way to find out is to check the family records.
Ah, breaking into Grandma and Grandpa's house.
Wait, what are you doing? They're sleeping in here.
Oh, please. They get so doped up on sleeping pills and liquor, an earthquake wouldn't wake them up.
My God, how does she sleep at night knowing she has to funnel this old duffer's hog?
This is it. Patrick Pewterschmidt, 56 Meadow Lane, Brookfield. I do have a brother. Oh, my God, I've got to meet him.
Oh, hey, Brian, you know what'd be fun?
Oh, God, totally.
Yeah! Awesome!
You know, sometimes the old-fashioned playthings are the best.
Hey, kids of America, it's hand-painted wooden ball in a cup. Who needs constant electronic video stimulation when there's ball in a cup? Mexico's favorite toy for over 340 years. Toss the ball, catch it in the cup, dump it out of the cup, toss it, and catch it in the cup again. The ball is on a string and attached to the cup, so there's no worry if you don't catch the ball in the cup.
All right, everyone, I'd like to get started. Okay, that's better. Welcome, everybody, to the snacks are best saved for later. Okay, now I've prepared an agenda for our organization, what we want from the community as fat people with pride. All right, I think we got a lot accomplished here today. We'll pick this up again tomorrow.
Can you believe I'm about to meet my long-lost brother? Maybe Dateline will do a story on us, huh? I'll get to meet that pompous ass Stone Phillips. He's the kind of guy you hate till he's inside you.
There it is, 56 Meadow Lane.
Brookfield Insane Asylum?
Oh my God, Mom's brother's crazy.
Oh no, I didn't catch the ball in the cup. Oh, wait a minute, it's okay, because the ball is on a string and attached to the cup.
Doctor, is my brother really insane?
Mrs. Griffin, we don't use the word insane. We prefer the term mentally hilarious.
Ooh, I can't wait to meet the lunatic.
Patrick?
Yes?
My name's Lois. I'm your sister.
Oh my God, Lois. I never thought I'd see you again.
These are my children.
When I was just a little boy, I had a very traumatic experience.
Mommy,
a drink of water? Jackie Gleason!
Beat it, kid. Your mother's busy.
I'm in a pow, right in the kisser.
Oh, that's a horrible story.
Yeah.
We are taking you back to Quahog with us.
Oh, that's a great idea. Maybe he can bring his sling blade and order up some French fried potatoes.
Thank God I'm out of that hospital.
Oh, Peter, there you are. This is my brother, Patrick.
Yeah, good to meet you, Patrick.
Oh, great. You gonna drop some weight, fat ass?
No, dummy. I'm gonna help make this a fat man's world.
I'm very glad you're here, Patrick.
Well, I want to tell you that Marion and I both appreciate what you've done.
Marion? Oh, you have a girlfriend.
Oh, where are my manners? Marion is my wife. She's sitting right next to me.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, nice to meet you, Marion.
What's that, honey? Oh, yes. Hang on, Marion wants some coffee. Lois, did you see that? He's nuts.
Brian, he's been locked up in that place for 30 years. It's perfectly understandable that he'd invent an imaginary companion.
Yes, he's even more imaginative than the people who invented singing.
Hey, guys, I'm going for a run. Do me a favor and keep Marion company while I'm gone.
Sure.
Great. Bye, honey.
We should let it sit here for a couple of weeks and see if it pickles. If after 3 weeks it pickles, then she's real and we both have to buy Patrick a steak.
One time when I was a boy...
Oh, I love Jackie Gleason. Hey, take a look at what I bought at this TV convention. It's a bus driver's uniform. Pow, right in the kisser.
Right in the kisser. Pow, right in the kisser. Pow, right in the kisser. Pow, right in the kisser.
Wow, that set him off like a Paul Schaefer fire alarm.
Hello?
Lois, it's your father. The hospital called and said you released Patrick. Have you lost your mind? He's incredibly dangerous.
Yourself for locking up your own son. Whose pickle is this?
Police release this sketch of the suspect.
Oh, my God.
Police also released this sketch of a female accomplice believed to be his wife. Hello, I'm Tom Tucker. Three more men have been killed, all of them very, very fat.
Lois, that sketch looks a lot like Patrick.
Oh, that's ridiculous. Patrick, where have you been?
Oh, it's nothing you need to concern yourself with, Lois.
Well, that's a relief.
This will be a bigger disaster than when Peter did Tara Reid's boob job.
He's one of our brothers. He was a good man. He was a kind man. He was a fat man.
We're finished!
Did someone tie my shoe?
People! I know what'll make us feel better. Elves at home. Lois, these are the fat guys. Fat guys, Lois.
My God, look at you fat bastards. I bet none of you can even find your own penis. Find your penis for a dollar. Find your penis, $1, $1, find your penis here.
Peter, what's going on?
Lois, my people are in danger. Until they find the fat guy strangler, we will stay here. Victor, don't lean against that.
Hey, everybody.
Peter, you gotta get these guys out of here. Patrick is the murderer.
What?
Don't listen to Brian.
Warm, buttery toast.
That sounds good.
I love toast.
I just found my penis.
Run, Patrick, run!
He went into James Woods. Let's spread out and find him.
We'll head him off at the...
Brian, I know my brother. He couldn't have done these things.
Well, let's see if you feel that way when you see this. Oh, yeah? What about the dead fat guy under his bed?
Coincidence?
What about the half-dead fat guy in the corner?
Patrick tried to kill me.
Well, maybe it's a different Patrick.
Lois!
Okay. Oh, my God. Peter's out there with him.
Wait! You gonna eat that dead fat guy?
It's uninterrupted.
Patrick, let him go, or Marion gets it.
Nice try, but Marion's over there.
Don't hurt her!
Now let him go!
Okay.
Ah, you missed!
No, I didn't. That's for rolling up the damn window when I tried to jump into the General Lee.
I'm sorry, Lois. I never meant to hurt anybody.
You're my brother, and you'll always be my brother.
I have to go back to the hospital, don't I?
Yeah.
Hit me in the face. It was like, pow, right in the kisser. Pow, right in the kisser. Pow, right in the kisser.
I miss Uncle Patrick.
Don't worry, kids. I promise we can visit him once a month.
We'll be his period.
I was just upstairs, and there's a half-dead fat guy eating a dead fat guy. Uh-huh. So I guess we're just looking the other way, huh?
What in blazes is this? I thought you said we were going to church!
This is church, Francis.
Please rise. Now sit on it. The fawns be with you.
And also with you.
Let us a...
A...
A reading from the letters of Potsy to the Tuscaderos. And saith he, reassembleth will I the pieces of my motorcycle, the only Negro in the state of Wisconsin. Amen.
Amen.
Brian, what's that smell?
Black spray paint.
What were you painting?
Ah! Damn it, I haven't been this dizzy since I did those helium whippets at that birthday party.
Peter, your religion is an abomination. I never thought you could ever embarrass me more in a church than you did at your cousin Mary's wedding.
And if anyone knows of any reason why these two should not be married, let him speak now.
Really? Nobody's gonna speak up. Genital warts! But, Dad, you're the one who said I should look into my heart to find my religion.
Yes, real religion. What I saw today wasn't religion. It was just a bunch of sheep singing songs and listening to ridiculous tall tales.
Why? I agree with you. All Peter's done is found another way to exploit people's ignorance, and that's just wrong.
You think I'm... See, Brian, that's a word the Fonz can't say. Because all is right when you welcome Fonzie into your life.
Reverend Peter, I gotta talk to you. Last night I had sex with a teenage blonde and her mother.
Who ascended the stairs with his basketball in season one and never came down again.
Hi, I'm Sherman Hemsley and I've just established the Church of George Jefferson. Who wants to move on up?
Hi, I'm Kirk Cameron.
Oh, great. You here to convert people to the Church of Mike Seaver?
No, I'm here to convert people to Christianity.
Okay. I can't believe it. Everybody's gone.
Well, people like that are always looking for the next voice to tell them what to do.
Major idiots.
Yeah. Well, gosh, you know, I guess we do have some common ground here after all, huh?
Oh, him too. I read somewhere. I think it was in, like Stuff? No. You know what it was? It was on Real Sports with Bryant Gumbel.
Oh, look at you. You're all better.
That's right, Brian. And you are toast. I'm gonna get in the gym, get my lats back, and then me and my friends from Cobra Kai are gonna take you down, man!
Sorry I had to rain on your parade, Peter.
That's all right, Brian. I guess the Church of the Fonz was just a bad idea.
Not really, Peter. You were preaching honesty, friendship, courage.
Thanks, Lois. But I doubt there's any chance of that.